everyone, to this very special showing of my senior capstone project, the Indie Game Big Band. So yes, we have a Minecraft, you know the rest, but I want to talk to you a little bit about how I started this whole project. A couple years ago, I worked with Professor David Marks, and I put together an arrangement of another video game song. It was called National Park from Pokemon, Pokemon Heart Gold and Soul Silver. I got together a few of my friends, and we played it during a wind ensemble and university orchestra concert. Shout out to Mr. Ming and Dr. Lipinski for that. And so after that, Professor Marks told me, hey, this is kind of like a capstone level project. And I heard it, I was like, really? Huh, okay. What might be the next big step? And that turned out to be, let's just put on a whole concert written and arranged by me of video game music, because I love, I just really love video game music, so. Now, I also love jazz, and so you're gonna hear many idioms that you might incorporate in this concert, and I'm really excited for you to hear that and maybe even recognize a few things. We're gonna get started with this first tune. It's from a game called Celeste. And if any of you know it, it's a game where you play as a protagonist, a middle-aged woman, pixelated form, and you climb a mountain and conquer your anxiety and depression. So she faces many obstacles on this journey, as well as a manifestation of her own anxiety and depression. So without further ado, we're gonna play you two songs from that. This first one is called Resurrections.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you.
Dane Cronister on piano over there. This next one takes us to a probably one of the later levels in the game. This is called Mirror Temple, and it's supposed to symbolize the reflections that we see in ourselves, naturally. During this, she finds herself lost in this mirror temple, Madeline, and transported to this otherworldly dimension. Now, lucky for us, this otherworldly dimension is also funky. So we took that this into this arrangement, and you'll hear a very funky side to this game. So this is Celeste Mirror Temple Magic Mix.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. That was Sammy Frescoli on trumpet. And Habib Rahman on trombone. As well as Dane Cronister once more. This next tune is from a very special game to me. I spent many hours here playing this game and just trying to be good at it because it is a very difficult and challenging game. This next one's from Hollow Knight. And we're going to be taking a bit of a journey to a more forgotten land, a more forgotten, desolate kingdom that fell. Kingdom of Bugs. So, if you're not into bugs, don't worry, there's none there. There's none here tonight. So, but we're gonna play this song for you. It's gonna be good. on trombone. And then the quartet that you heard at the end. And then myself, yours truly, on saxophone. All right, I hope you all are ready to clap along, because this next one's gonna be a fun one. Next, we're gonna take a look at Cuphead. Yeah, there we go. So, in a string of looking at very challenging games to play, this one is no exception. let's see. This one is about two boys, Cuphead people, whatever you want to call them. If you haven't figured it out already, games are pretty weird. But they end up wandering into the casino of the devil, and they go on a winning streak, and then eventually roll snake eyes. And you don't want to do that in the casino of the devil. So they, of course, had to plea for their lives, and they were sent on a mission to, well, go collect souls, become soul debtors. And that's how we get to the current events of the game. And during this, we get one of my favorite tunes from this game is called Floral Fury. And in it, you find a giant flower, and that's one of the debtors. That's one of the people who owes their soul to the devil. So this one's gonna be fun. Cool Latin beat for you all, so I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
That featured our lovely horn section over there. Get a load of those guys. They're great, right? All right. And next on the list, we're gonna bring out one of our first vocalists here, Renae George. And we're gonna take a turn to a very strange story. All of these are strange, actually. into a game called Skullgirls. Now, if any of you know it, it's a fighting game that became popular within the last 10 years or so, and it's got a very convoluted story, so I won't get into that. However, all you have to know is it's got really good music. You should check it out. For this one, we're going to be playing the end credits theme, and it's going to be sung by, a special character in it. But anyways, I digress. This is In a Moment's Time.
Tonight, just another day that didn't go your way. Well, don't you make a sigh, just take my hand, don't toss and turn, just lie awake. In just a moment's time, you'll wonder why you ever thought you'd ever look for more than you've got, 'cause baby, you've got. Just a moment's time, you'll wonder why you ever thought.
Bahia e Guira. Buen dia, yo barita le te tui papa. But we dui bai, 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 dui
Renae George, everyone. All right. I'm glad you all enjoyed that one. Now we're moving on to something that's could possibly be considered an indie game now. I think it's gotten a lot of attention in the last 10 years, and several people asked me before, was like, is this really an indie game? And I was like, yeah, it technically was when it first came out. so we're doing it. And it's music that you all know and love. It's this is going to be a medley from Minecraft. So, yeah. So we had to do it, right? So, yep. We're gonna take a turn, calm it down a little. Just be sure not to nod off during this one. We'll be all good. All right. This is Minecraft. Thank you. Thank you. And real quick, I want to give a shout out to all the audio and video people who have helped me with this project. Again, without stage or even off stage that's been involved with this project, this would not have been at all. So let's give a round of applause for our audio and video techs that have helped us out here. For this next one, we're going to bring out a little bit of the acoustic guitar, as well as our guitar player, Logan Brazeal. And we're going to take another step to another game that came out in 2012. It won Game of the Year that year. It ended up being pretty well received at its time. This one's Journey. And if you didn't think that orchestra, and one of the biggest challenges for me as an arranger was taking that and applying it to this band here. You see a jazz big band orchestra setting, because all of it is very string and heavy focused. Well, it's heavily string focused. So I decided to go that route, but I also decided to add my own flavor to it as well. So you'll hear a little bit of that. This is our Journey medley.
Thank you.
That's Brendan Zasek on the cello and Errett Corbiere on the violin. Now we're going to take another Game of the Year winner. This one won in 2020. If you know the game Hades is a really cool game. Each time you go through it, something new happens. So you're supposed to die in the game. It's very different from conventional games and how you think about it, where you're supposed to progress through a certain level or story or a certain amount of cutscenes without dying. Well, this one, that's the point. This one follows the story of Zagreus, the son of Hades, as he tries to escape hell or the underworld, and as he tries to escape and find his mother. So this one will be having a look at two of the songs from that game. We'll be taking a look at Good Riddance and In the Blood. Hope you enjoy.
To all the
All right, well, unfortunately, this brings us to the end of our program tonight. But thank you so much for coming out tonight. You've been a great audience. And yeah, really glad that you enjoy the music that we've been putting out. We've worked really hard all semester long. And yeah, nothing would happen without these guys' hard work. So let's give another round of applause for our wonderful musicians. All right, so for our last piece, we'll be taking a look at one of the most popular indie video games that came out this last century. I was about to say century. This last decade. A little game called Undertale. So, oh yeah. We're going to be looking at some of the most popular songs from that game. And I'll just shut up. I'll let the music do the talking.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, everyone, for coming out. A very special shout out to all the faculty and staff that helped me with this project. Thank you so much for listening to me and my crazy ambition. But here we are now. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you, everyone. Good night.